all right, the time is 2:32 on Thursday, and I'm going to see if I can break the world record, the world's smallest deck of cards. The entire deck must measure less than 7 millimeters by 5 millimeters by 4.86 millimeters. This record is held by a man who currently has 18 world records, and he's aiming for 100. And when asked why he does it, he says, just for fun. So I hope he doesn't mind if I take one unofficially. And I say unofficially because his record is recognized by Guinness, the main governing body of world records. And I personally have some experience with this because my dad broke a world record a few years ago. Everyone picked up interesting skills during COVID, and my dad's goal was to break a world record, something he's always wanted to do. He successfully ran through the most paper banisters in 1 minute. So now, 3D Luke is here to claim the throne of the world's smallest deck of cards. Let's get into it.
So here's my thought process.
Boring, but we gotta do it so you see where I'm coming from.
Each layer, each card is gonna be 0.05. It's gonna be one layer, and that's why it's so important that it's precise. The easy part is that 7 by 5, that's just the profile of the card. So in order to beat this, I'm gonna keep the same 7 by 5, but I'll do like 6 millimeter, 4.286. So it's gonna be half of this height. And you're probably wondering, where, how are you gonna mark the cards? And we'll get to that. Let's just design the flat card first.
So literally just made a box and then used the dimensions we just figured out.
Export to the slicer and tweak the print settings. Slice it, which creates the G code that my printer will read and move the nozzle according to the G code. And now we'll print it.
All right, the cards are on the build plate, and now I'm going to make the stencil to distinguish each card from each other. And this is probably going to take a lot more time, but
I'll be right back.
What I'm doing right here is creating the stencil case. And then we'll add the letter and the suit of the card. This is the Ace of Hearts, and we're actually gonna test it out first before we do all the other cards.
So the cards are done, and that's a penny for scale. They are tiny.
I'm gonna use a heat gun to try to kind of like congeal the layers down a little bit more before I try to take them off. I don't wanna melt the cards. If you look though, these cards down here look a lot better than the ones starting up here, but these ones look like they'll break more, so I may need to print more, but we'll see. I'm gonna give it a few minutes until I take them off.
Let's see if we can carefully remove some of these. God, this is tedious.
So here is the stencil. The card will go underneath on the back side, and then I'll just apply a little bit of spray paint. So let's see if we can make one card and then see if the concept will work.
Oh. That was way too much.
We're counting that.
Behold, the Ace of Hearts. These stencils are gonna be really hard to print 52 different types. So I'm just gonna grab a Sharpie. I've proven that I can do it with a stencil, and we're going for time at this point because we have all the cards. We just need to print the box and write all the card type on each of the cards.
All right, it is 8:40, and I just had an absolute disaster. I broke the heat cartridge cord to my Prusa Mini. And then I broke the fan shroud to my MK3S, and then my nozzle wouldn't screw in, and I'm pretty sure I f***ed the whole extruder. I screwed it up.
Okay, it's not that deep, but I am obviously hurt by this for whatever reason. I've spent 6 hours on it, come on.
Like, I don't have a 3D printer. Like, I can't print. I have all 52 cards, and I don't have the, like, container for it, so I'm gonna make it out of paper, and that's not what I wanted to do. I still think I could break the world record, just not in the way I wanted to, but it is what it is.
Drama queen. All right, let's just carry on.
All right, so this is the container, and actually it does give me a bit more freedom to make the squish the cards in there, so that's the case. I wish I could have 3D printed it. I really did. That's my whole shtick here, but this is gonna have to do for today.
All right, here's the deal. I'm not happy with how this is turning out. This is not how I want to break the unofficial world record. So this is gonna be a part one. I am so sorry, but I've gotta fix my 3D printers and figure this out. So thank you for watching and expect part two whenever I get my stuff together. Again, I wanted to do this in one day. I just can't. So consider this a new series because I am determined to break this world record.